And I just want to say the 11th chapter because I'm going to hit some verses in this, but I'll call them out. We'll start at Hebrews 11, verse 8. By faith, Abraham, when he was called to go out into a place which he should after receive for an inheritance, obeyed. And he went out, not knowing whether he went. Verse 13, these all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off and were persuaded of them and embraced them and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on earth. Verse 22, by faith Joseph, when he died, made mention of the departing of the children of Israel and gave commandment concerning his bones. Verse 24, by faith Moses, when he was called come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasure of sin for a season. Verse 31, by faith the harlot Rahab perished not with them that believed not when she received the spies with them. And what shall I say more? The time would fail me to tell of Gideon, of Barak, of Samson, of Jephthah, of David, also in Samuel, who through faith subdued kingdoms, wrought righteousness, obtained promise, stopped the mouth of lions, quenched the violence of fire, escaped the edge of the sword, out of weakness were made strong, waxed valiant in fight, turned to the flight the enemies. Women received the dead raised. Others were tortured and not accepted deliverance that they might attain a better resurrection. Others had trial of cruel mockings and scourging, yea, moreover of bonds and imprisonment. They were stoned, they were sawed asunder, they were tempted, they were slain with the sword. They wandered about in sheepskin and goatskin, being destitute, afflicted, and tormented, of whom the world was not worthy. They wandered in the desert and in the mountains and in dens and caves of the earth. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor,
is
what we do.
It's what we do.
You may be seated.
All right.
Neighbor, is what we do. I have a home phone that we got with Suddenlink when we hooked up cable, because it was cheaper to get the bundle than for just one service. So we was able to get cable, the internet, and a telephone. It's a telephone we never use. And it's a telephone we don't give out the number to because we don't use it. And so we get calls on this phone, and we usually 99% let it ring, because we know nobody knows us, because we didn't give out the number to nobody. It just came with the internet and it made it cheaper. And so this morning while I was sitting at my desk and the phone is on my desk, it rang. And for whatever the reason, I decided to answer it. And they asked me for some person name in Spanish. They asked it in English, but it was a Spanish name. And I said, no, they don't live here. And I said, thank you. But before I finished saying thank you, I said, hey. She said, yes. I said, can I ask you a question? I said, not that I'm upset or anything, because you know, the person doesn't live here. But why would you call somebody on Sunday? Being a bill collector, that's what it was.
Yeah.
Why would you call on a Sunday? And the girl said, it's what we do. It's what we do. And when I hung that call up, I looked at my wife who was at her desk, and I laughed. I told the girl, good answer. But for some reason, it struck me. This is what she was doing, her job. It's what she did. And she said, that's what we do. In other words, she meant, we are here to make calls to people that owe us money, and we call.
Well,
it's what we do. Whether it's Sunday, whether it's Saturday, whether it's up to 10 o'clock, that's what we do. And I began to think. And I began to think. It's what we do. And I thought of the movie Black Hawk Down, if you ever seen it. It is a powerful war movie. A true story about Meshelbeek, I think, where the airborne Rangers, the Rangers, lost a helicopter when they were going after it. Black Hawk Down is a 2001 war film produced by Jerry Bruckheimer, directed by Riley Scott. It was based on the true book in the film called The Battle of Motion Beak or whatever. It was about the 93 raid of the United States to capture Samoan warlord. In the raid, a task force called Delta Soldiers, they got a helicopter shot down. What was supposed to be a couple hour mission turned into 15 hours. Because the rule was no one gets left behind. And so Staff Sergeant Hoot Gibson, he was called Norman Hoot Gibson, he was asked a question. He said, when I get home and people ask me, hey Hoot, why do you do it, man? Why? Are you some kind of war junkie? I won't say a word. They won't understand why we do it. They won't understand it's about the men next to you. And that is it. We do what we do because it's what we do. Herein in the Bible, Abraham was called by God to go to a place he's never been to before. But because he believed God, he went and traveled. And if people would have asked Abraham, why are you going to a place you don't even know? He said, I believe he would have said, it's what we do. When you live for God, you trust God.
Yeah.
You believe God. It's just what we do. You see, when the Hebrew boys were told to bow down in front of the statue, they refused. They said, oh, King, we're not careful to answer you in this matter. But being known unto you, we will not bow down to your statue.
Wow, wow.
And the God that we serve is able to deliver us.
Amen.
But even if he doesn't, we shall be delivered from you.
Wow, wow.
Even in death, we'll escape. And if you would have asked the Hebrew boys, why are y'all willing to go into the fiery furnace? I believe they would have said, it's what we do.
Amen.
We are children of God, and we only stand for one person, and that is the Lord God Almighty.
Amen.
All right.
You ask me why I'm going into the fire, like Mr. Hoots, you wouldn't understand. You wouldn't understand why we get up every Sunday morning and darken the doorsteps to the church. But that's what we do.
Amen.
Even when we're sick and afflicted and don't feel well, we try to make it because that's what we do.
Amen.
Right?
It is because not only who we are, it is because whose we are.
Yes, amen. Yes.
It's what we do.
Amen.
As the people of God, we are willing for our God to go through hell and high water.
Yes.
Because it's what we do for him. Our God, who did what he did for you and I.
Amen.
Yes, yes, yes.
When I get home, people ask me, hey, who? Why do you do it, man? Why? Are you some kind of war junkie? I won't say a word because they don't understand why we do it.
Amen.
People don't understand when you tell them, hey, are you coming over? some nervous, and no, I gotta go. We got some things going on at the church. Well, why are you always doing stuff at the church? You won't understand it, man. It's what we do.
Amen.
All right.
We're a family different from any other family.
Yeah.
Amen.
It's what we do.
Oh, okay.
We fellowship. We laugh. We got, me and Nari were talking, we got more funny things that has happened in this church than any place I know. We got more stories to talk, laugh, things to laugh about in this church that we can sit back and just laugh about the things that go on. Like Brother Jeff, when we were barbecuing years back, and it was at nighttime, and Brother Jeff had that shovel, and the fire was burning, and Jeff was over there, and he wouldn't leave the fire alone. He was just turning that fire. And Jim was sitting over there. It's the only time I think I let a person smoke a cigar sitting down in the backyard there. He was sitting up there. Are you no Narver? Well, I know you're doing just right. Yeah, Narver, you know. He was just sitting up there. And when we were cooking pancakes and stuff, and I walked past Narver, and he put his secret sauce into the mix. And I'm thinking, hey! What you done? He said, what you complaining about? You ain't never said nothing about the secret sauce yet. and it ain't even time to me that we had one man that was eating the chicken, and he was just licking up the sauce. Wow! It's just what we do. I'm trying to see what's happening to your plate. when we fixing pancakes, and Brother Jeff's over there, he goes from one place to another. And when we serve him food, and we ran a low on cornbread, I look for Harold, and Harold done took off with somebody to go deliver food instead of cooking cornbread. And we run short.
You ain't gonna never let me live that one down here.
And Brother Harold, well, I didn't know. We looked around for Brother Harold. Brother Harold was gone. And we sat back, and we laughed. And Ivory makes up stories about me and fire in the street. Barbecue, y'all. But it's what we do.
Amen.
Because we're family, we're children of God, that we get together and we cry together, we get upset together, we hurt together. But it's what we do. Yes, sometimes things get hard. Yes, sometimes when the going gets tough, we want to get going, and sometimes we do. But we come back because this is what we do.
Yes, amen. Yes, amen. Amen.
And outside of God, that's all we got. Oh, we realize that Jesus is the answer.
Yes, he is.
You see, as a soldier in the army, I am designed to be a fighter. It's what we do. Herein, Daniel, when he was knew the decree was signed, he still went to his window like he did every day and prayed. And if the king would have said, Daniel, why did you pray even after you knew the decree was signed? Daniel would have said, it's what I do.
Amen, amen.
I pray. I seek God. I trust God. I believe God because it is what we do. I want you to know, children, war is coming.
Well.
And it may cost some of us our lives.
Well.
But you cannot fail to finish. You must finish the race that is set before you. Why? Because it's what we do. When we were watching movies, there is a movie of a young man, a track star, who was expected to win the meet. And in the midst of him running, he tore a muscle in his leg. And he went down, and he got up and started hopping like this, and he was in pain. And his father came out of the stands. And the officials were trying to grab the father. The father pushed him out of the way. And he put his hands around his son, and his son hugged him. And you could see him holding his head because of the pain he was in. But the son told the father, And the father and both the son was going like this around the track. The son says, I gotta finish.
Amen.
Even with the torn muscles in his leg. And when he got close enough, the father let go of the son. And the son went across the finish line. If you would have asked that young runner, why'd you do that? Why didn't you just quit? He said, it's because I'm a runner. Amen. And this is what I do.
Yes.
I was made to run. Even with my injury, even with my pain, even with the tear of my leg, I still have to finish.
Yes.
And even with your pain, even with the tears in your life, you were made to finish the race for the Lord.
Amen.
Even when you fall, even when you fail, you get back up and you keep on, even if you come in on broken pieces.
Amen.
Jesus. Because we must finish the race. For the race is not to the swift. The battle is not to the strong. But it's to the one that finishes. Oh, it don't matter what place you come in. You're still a winner with God.
Amen, as long as you come in.
Even if you come in last, you still win with God.
Amen.
But in order to win, you got to come in.
Amen, amen.
You got to come in. It is what we do. Now, I know I'm 58. I don't know how old I am. You probably changed some numbers on me, I don't know. But we were out there with his children and my children a while back playing basketball. And I think I was injured. I was injured. And I was watching them play. Whatever that Nyree age he was trying to show, he still had it. I don't know if he went home and took a bath and put himself in some Epsom salt after that. But if you would have asked Nyree why he does, this is what we do. We old school. We're going to show those youngsters they can't outplay us. You know? But it's what we do. It's what we do. No matter what you go through in life, you can't quit, church. You can't give up. No matter how bad things look, and sometimes they do look bad.
Wow.
But even in the midst of your darkness, there's always a ray of light.
Amen.
Do you not know that the clouds right now can get deathly black? Lightning could flash and thunder could roar. But even while it's dark and raining and thundering down here at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, the sun is still shining above the storm.
Yes.
And because the sun is still shining, we keep on going on. Why? Because that's what we do. Yes, the lady surprised me when I asked her. I said, ma'am, I don't mean no harm. I'm not upset that you called because the woman you want doesn't live here. But I got to ask you, what will make you call somebody about a bill on a Sunday? And she, as plain as a matter of fact, she said, just straight up, that's what we do. And when she said that, it made me laugh. Because if we could have that kind of tenacity, if we would have that kind of ability to get together when we say no matter what happens, to have fellowship with one another no matter what, say I'm going to the fellowship, I'm going to the barbecue, I'm going over to the pastor's house, over to Nyree's house, I'm coming to the church to eat, I'm going, why are you going? Because that's what we do.
Amen.
We're gonna have a yard cleaning. That's what we do. We help each other out. Let's show up.
Amen.
Let's not just one or two, my three and four, no more. Let everybody show up because it's what we do.
Amen.
Why? Because we are gonna be known. How are we gonna be known? By what we do.
Amen.
For they shall know you by the love that you have one towards another.
Amen.
Oh, people don't listen to what you say. They look at what you do.
Amen.
People don't care what comes out of your mouth. They want to know the action behind what comes out of your mouth.
Yes. Amen.
It's never what you say. It's always what you do. It's always what you do. It's always what you do. If we're going to be the church of God, we can't keep talking about we're going to be the church. We can't keep always talking about we're going to. Gonna never got anything done.
Amen.
We're going to have to do what we say because it's what we do. We got to get up. Everybody wants to know about Martin Luther King. I have a dream. 50 years later, we shouldn't be dreaming.
Amen.
We ought to be putting things in action.
Amen.
We got problems if you still hear me say, I'm still having a dream. Well, when you gonna wake up from the dream and have some action for what you dreamt about?
Amen.
Oh, we got to arise if we're gonna be the church that God wants us to be.
Amen.
Yes.
We're gonna have to invite people because that's what we do as Christians. When you go shopping, people always call me and say, hey, Dick's got a sale on night, and everybody, Dick's got a good sale on me. Oh, you know. Because Nairi kind of know how to barbecue. Nairi will call me up, and I don't know. Now I can say this because he's here. I don't know why he called me up to tell me what he barbecues. Because I can't barbecue, so I think he just likes calling me and say, guess what I barbecue today? And Pastor, don't you know that it was wrapped up? So, I don't know what that is. And don't you know I put this flavor into it? And you know, and I'm on the phone. And when I sliced it, who passed it? And you know what I think him and Angela's doing? Laughing. I ain't proved that yet, but I'm gonna pay one of those kids to tell me. And he said, I just sliced it. Oh, Pastor, I cooked some chicken and I twisted the bone and it just came out. Well, if I twist your bone, it's gonna come off. Oh, and why do you tell me? Because he said it's what we do. Because he knows that when he cooks it, I'm gonna say, did you gonna blame me a plate? You gonna break me a plate, or you just gonna tell me what we do? Well, that's what we do. That's what we do. And I mean that because that's what we do. He'll call me up, and then I called him yesterday. I told my wife, I don't need Nairi to barbecue now. I learned some things. I learned some things from my job. And so guess what I did? I called Nairi. I said, yeah, we did some cooking on my job, and I learned some things. And I learned that you take some mustard, and you can put it on the chicken skin or some mayonnaise. Then I got to talking to him, I said, oh, I think you told me that, didn't you? He said, it's made, and I'm talking, Gary telling me it's made to hold the seasoning on better. And I said, yeah, they use that to hold the seasoning and stuff on better. Anyway, guess what else they do? They take brown sugar and they put it on the ribs. Uh-huh. Well, I don't like sweet ribs anyway. You know why? That's not what I do. But we call each other. Why? Because that's what we do. If he doesn't hear from me, you ain't talking to me, lady? What's wrong? You ain't calling me? Why does it? Because that's what we do. We fellowship. We are friends. We're family. And if we're going to be the children of God, then this is what we do.
Amen.
We come to the house of God. We worship. We ask people for forgiveness, and we give forgiveness, and we move on.
Amen.
We be the best we can do. We wipe away some tears every now and then. We put a smile on some face, and we mend broken hearts, wounded knees, and broken toys because this is what we do.
Amen.
And if we will remember who we are, whose we are, and what mission God has, then we'll understand Luke 4:18. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the brokenhearted. It's what
Amen.
Amen.
Let's
everybody, Junior. He's on the Junior in here. I expect you to have three or four of your friends here next time. And you. And you don't invite them and you don't be here. For all of us to bring one.
Amen.
Oh, if we were cooking, everybody'd be here. We get folks we don't even know who they are. We gotta ask them. I told Tyree, the woman walked in, had a dress on like she was Pentecostal. Well, she walked in, that woman better. I think it was one plate. But I know she was. And I said, Nigel, that's somebody you brought? Oh, somebody you brought? I don't even know who she is. You know? And we just laugh because it's what we do. It's what we do. We don't give plates out, people on the street. But it's just so funny because it's what we do.
Amen.
That the lives that we touch and don't even know it is what we do as the people of God. So come on, y'all. Let's be who we are by showing it. We don't work to get saved. We work because we are saved.
Amen, amen.
We can't be saved because of works, but we have works because we are saved. Yes. It's by the grace of God. It's who we are. And this is what we do. Let's win souls for Jesus and build up his kingdom for him. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Father God, we thank you for this opportunity to come before your throne of grace. In your throne of mercy. We ask for your guidance and your direction. We ask that you would mend broken hearts, fix wounded knees and broken toys. That you would just bless those that are sick and afflicted, God, those that are struggling, those that have pain. Yes, you're the great doctor. We ask that Dr. Jesus would touch hearts and bring his co-companions, Dr. Grace and Dr. Mercy, into the lives of people that are hurting and are struggling. We ask that you wipe away tears, fears, heartache, and pain. And let us show forth the praises of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. Because this is what we do. In Jesus' name, the church say,
amen.
Amen. Amen.
Y'all dismissed in Jesus' name.